I'm here with Rushy from Evolution Studios. You've brought MotorStorm RC with you on PS3 and on PS Vita. And I think the first question is it's a question of scale. It's obviously MotorStorm shrunk, but in terms of the cars and the the vehicles rather, and the tracks, is it still a full scale MotorStorm experience?
Yeah, absolutely. What we've done, we've taken the MotorStorm universe from all the previous games, Monument Valley, Pacific Rift, Arctic Edge, and MotorStorm Apocalypse, and we've taken it to a new sort of gameplay. You know, it's just shrunk down to be racing with RC vehicles. You've still got your racing trucks, your big rigs, your super minis, supercars, etc., which all offer unique handling styles, but you are racing these little vehicles. It's less about the brutal competition between each vehicle and more about finessing your lines and trying to get your best times to beat your friends online.
I mean, before MotorStorm, Evo were really a thoroughbred racing studio, you know, still are. Was it quite nice to go back to that, you know, meticulous lap chasing
gameplay? Yeah, it's actually been quite a refreshing change. I mean, we've loved working on the previous MotorStorm games, and you know, they've been brutal, over-the-top action games. But it's been really good to go back to a nice, simple, kind of old-school, classic addictive gaming. And we found that it's really compulsive, the game. Once you pick it up, you start scoring a few lap times, you start seeing what your friends are doing, and you just can't put it down, and it's a real nice change.
We touched on there, you said to me earlier that social interaction was really at the heart of what you were trying to do. Can you elaborate on that?
Yeah, well, because of the Vita's Wi-Fi and 3G capabilities, we've integrated what we call the pit wall, and this is like a social activity feed within inside the game where you can see what your friends are doing at all times. So whether they've just posted a lap time on a different track to you, or whether they've just beaten one of your times, you can see exactly what they're doing at all times. And within seconds, you can go to the pit wall and you can jump onto that track, download their ghost, and be playing against them, you know, for some friendly rivalry between friends.
And the user experience of playing on PS3 or on PS Vita and then taking it to the other platform, exactly how's that journey going to work?
Well, the PlayStation 3 and the Vita version are essentially the same. But what we do, because it's not two individual products, it's like MotorStorm RC as a service. And if you buy into one, you get the other. And everything you do, whether it's on the Vita or the PlayStation 3, is saved to the cloud. And then on the cloud, it's then transferred to both platforms. So if I'm playing at home in the evening and then take my Vita to work, over lunchtime I can be playing, picking up my progress and being exactly where I left off.
You've had a relatively short development schedule on this. It's been a quick turnaround, hasn't it? Do you think that shows the ease of development for the Vita? Has it been a good experience?
Yeah, absolutely. We've been extremely surprised and pleased to work with the Vita because it's been so quick. And when we only started, earlier on this year, and we've been able to get the Vita version up and running in next to no time, the tools have been a real joy to work with. And it basically allowed us to be able to, release when the Vita's launched in February.
Okay, perfect. Thanks a lot, and we'll go check it out.